Our True Parents Way podcast this week is a classic radio broadcast of Holy Mary's Blessing from Halloween of 2015. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Holy Marriage Blessing, the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Wanda. Our topic this week is marriage in spirit world. And we are moving up toward Halloween, which is a celebration that some people love it. I think actually a lot of people love it because Halloween is the second largest commercially the second largest holiday in the calendar year in America, next only to Christmas. So people really do get into Halloween, and Halloween is all about what? Spirit world. And All Hallows Eve, and the next day is All Saints Day. We're going to talk about that next week. But the point I wanted to make is spirit world is real. When we leave this physical life, we enter upon a world of love, where love is the air, and we breathe love created by God as our eternal home. Now the question is, will we be able to breathe love there in the spiritual world? Will you? Will I? That's why we are on the earth, is to learn how to breathe love, how to give and take love with our brothers and sisters, with our parents and children, and most especially with our spouse, our husband and our wife. Is there free flowing love? Can we make the conditions of openness, of sharing, of giving, of comfort, of trust between each other, so that we can breathe love, so that our relationship becomes an atmosphere of love? That's what we take with us into the spirit world. Jesus said, there's no marriage in the resurrection. What did he mean by that? We don't have our spouse till death do you part, and then it's farewell and it's been nice knowing you. Something in our conscience, something in our original mind and heart doesn't want to separate ever. Death is not the barrier. The crucifixion, the cross, the resurrection goes beyond that. And yet, why did Jesus say there's no marriage in the resurrection? We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about marriage in the spirit world. Stay with us. I'm going to invite Pastor Ruth to offer our opening prayer. Pastor Ruth.
Our dear, most and beloved, loving Heavenly Parent, true parents of heaven and earth and mankind, and our beloved Lord Jesus, we come once again before you this morning. Father, as we open our hearts to you, Heavenly Father, in praise and worship, and Heavenly Father, as we dedicate this time, Heavenly Father, to have communion with you. Father, we want to invite your spirit. We want you, Heavenly Father, to inspire us, Heavenly Father, with your words that you have prepared for us this morning, that can uplift us, and Heavenly Father, feed our spirit, Father, which you desired that it would grow, Heavenly Father, and that we could grow and resemble you, Heavenly Father, for you created us, Heavenly Father, through your word, and you wanted us, Heavenly Father, to grow, Heavenly Father, by your word, and Heavenly Father, to ultimately, Father, become your incarnation. Yes. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you that, Heavenly Father, today you are teaching us, and Heavenly Father, bringing us, Father, into your embrace. Heavenly Father, through the words of our true parents, through the words of our Lord Jesus, that Father, are giving us life, Heavenly Father, that was lost because of the fall, reviving us, and Heavenly Father, awakening us, and Heavenly Father, bringing us to understand your ideal, your will, and Heavenly Father, what we need to do in order, Heavenly Father, to become your true sons and daughters. Father, we are so grateful, and Heavenly Father, again, we invite you to share with us this moment. We invite your Spirit, the Spirit of our Lord Jesus, and the Spirit of our true parents to be with us. And Heavenly Father, that this Spirit may reach out, Heavenly Father, to all of our listeners, to all, Heavenly Father, who are seeking, Heavenly Father, to be reconnected with you. We thank you and love you, and we offer this prayer humbly in the name of the Lord. Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Ruth. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, and it's the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. Now, our topic again, marriage in spirit world. And whatever, one thing we can definitely say about this topic is that it's something to prepare for, that it's coming in the future. And we know, no matter who we are, rich, poor, young or old, in or out, up or down, we're going to be, now our stay on this earth is temporary, and we're going to somewhere else after we're here. And faithful believers in God, people who are of the book, of the Bible, of the Quran, just about any spiritual tradition acknowledges there is a land beyond this land. There's a life beyond this life. Even the, you know, scientists, so much evidence, it's almost irrefutable. It's almost like you have to ignore the evidence in order to persist in the belief otherwise. Spiritual world is waiting for us, the world of the next life. What's going to happen there? Now, Jesus said, there's no marriage in the resurrection. And I've thought about that. He went on to say, because we're like angels there. Now, are human beings angels? Are angels somehow better than us? Actually, we as unificationists, we look at the biblical point of view. Paul said, you're to judge the angels. Human beings are God's children. Angels are God's servants. We have the closest relationship of love with God. We are created in God's image, male and female. Angels are not, they have no physical body. God created us with a physical body so that we could marry, so that we could unite, create marriage, create families, create lineages, create a world in which God could dwell, a world of joy and creativity, a world of teeming with life. That's what the whole creation is about. And so, and once we live in the kingdom of heaven where God dwells with us on the earth, we go to the kingdom of heaven in spirit world. But Jesus said, what is bound on earth is bound in heaven. So we have the kingdom of heaven on earth, and then we have it in the next world. But Jesus did not see true marriages on earth. And so he had to say, there's no marriage in the resurrection, because what's going on earth, in Jesus, from God's, the viewpoint of God's ideal, is not the marriage that God intended for us to have. Sad to say, God did not intend divorce, not at all. God did not intend family breakdown, tension, difficulties between husband and wife. That came because of the fall of man, the human fall, where Adam and Eve failed as a husband and wife. They left the garden. They hid their lower parts in shame. They were ashamed of the very parts of their body that made them one flesh, which is God, what God wanted them to become, and they became ashamed of it. It means they misused their reproductive organs. They left the garden, and that was what everything is about, the reproductive organs creating the most important thing in the universe, human beings, God's children, God's image. And so Jesus had to say, there's no marriage in the resurrection. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing. the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Israel. And I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Mwanda. And the good news is that the day of the marriage of the Lamb is upon us, and that everything has changed because the marriage has come. And marriage is now sanctified totally, entirely through the true parents, called by Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit, and Bible-based. Reverend Sun Myung Moon and Dr. Hak John Moon, a married couple, establishing the unity of oneness of husband and wife centered on God, the Trinity on the earth, Christ and the Holy Spirit embodied in the powerful love of God, expanding and saving us as families. That's the good news of our age. And so there is marriage and resurrection, and that's in the resurrection. There is marriage in the spirit world. I'm going to turn the mic over to Pastor Ruth to share with us the teachings about marriage in the spirit world. Pastor Ruth.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hendricks. And our topic again is marriage and the spirit world. And I'll read, and these are words of our true father, the Reverend Sun Myung Moon. Christianity teaches people to love God, but this is a vague concept. In the Bible, Jesus said, "You shall love your Lord, your God, with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the great and the first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. All you need are these two commandments. Before you love God, you have to love the food you eat, love all the things of the creation, and love your body. Then why do we marry? It is so that we resemble God. God is the uniformly combined being of dual characteristics. Since man and woman are divided expression of God's dual characteristics, they have to unite as one body, become like seeds, and return to God's position of original character. However, because we must go the way of love in order to be linked to that seed, we must be born in love, set love as our goal while growing up, live centering on love, and walk this path in order to return to love. You will go off in the wrong direction unless you follow the path centering on the goal of living for the sake of others." So what is marriage? Marriage is for women to learn what they do not know about men. Men have to learn what they do not know about women. You have to understand this. Marriage is the program to learn about the opposite sex. The reason we give birth to children and live for them is to learn how to love the world. Sons and daughters can connect us to the world and the future. If we do not have sons and daughters, we cannot be connected to the future. We have to understand that God gave us children as a source of education to connect us to the future world. And then our ancestors, our grandparents, are the source of education about the spirit world. If we take care of our grandparents with filial piety, that kind of system exists in the spirit world. This is for you to receive the education about the spirit world. What can be the center of this? Under the title of love, everything can be connected. Centered on love, everything can be connected. grandfather, grandmother, husband, and wife, sons and daughters can be connected all together, centered on love. If you have that love, you can be connected to millions of generations of your ancestors in the spirit world. You can also be connected to the descendants only with this love. First, you have to establish the kingdom of heaven as an individual. Next, you have to establish the kingdom of heaven as a couple. Where is the kingdom of heaven as a couple? Where is it? That is the place where plus and minus become totally united as one. Now, do you understand what the kingdom of heaven as a couple? Nobody can separate the couple who are completely attached together. What kind of love are you looking for? True love. True love. You can achieve that kind of love when your mind and body are completely united. The kingdom of heaven as a couple can emerge. After that, what will happen? Are you satisfied with only the kingdom of heaven as a couple? How can the kingdom of heaven as a couple emerge? When father and mother become totally one and love each other, the son will think he wants to marry a bride just like his mother, and the daughter will think she wants to marry a bridegroom just like her father. When the father and mother as a plus and the sons and daughters as minus are totally united as a family, that is the kingdom of heaven as a family. The place where the kingdom of heaven can be established in the family is the place where the kingdom of heaven can be established on earth, which is God's ideal. The four-position foundation has to be formed. The principle says that the completion of God's ideal of creation is the completion of the four-position foundation. Why do things have to be like this? Centered on three stages by God, Adam and Eve, the vertical world and horizontal world can be expanded. This is the principle. And may God bless these words. And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And our topic again is marriage and the spirit world. And from our reading, we read about Jesus emphasizing about the two great commandments, to love God with all our heart and mind, and the second is to love thy neighbor as you love thyself. Who are our first neighbors? It is your spouse and your family. After accomplishing the first commandment, to love God, you have to love your neighbor, who makes you a complete image of God, and that is your spouse. You should love him or love her as you love God, otherwise you cannot resemble God. From our reading, again, we learned that the three angels that guide you to heaven are your grandparents, the spouse, and the children. We have to love our grandparents, and with filial piety, we serve them, and under that circumstance, they connect us to our ancestors and ultimately to God. The children represent the future and connect us to the future. The children also live what they see. And if your couple is harmonized, it's peaceful, and you live a happy life, they want to follow the same example. This is the beginning of the kingdom of heaven. However, we all know that because of the fall, the Bible says marriage is until death parts. And therefore, there is no marriage in heaven. Today, through our true parents, they have come to liberate marriage. And through our true parents today, the Lord of the Second Advent, they have opened the gates of marriage in the king here in the physical world and also in the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, after we receive the blessing, our marriages are to live for eternity. This is the beginning of the kingdom of God here on earth and also in the spirit world. You are all invited to experience these new marriages that can live for eternity and have a happy family, a happy marriage for eternity. And may God bless you all.
And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks. And we just heard our co-host, Pastor Ruth Mwanda, sharing Father Moon's teachings and her reflections on how we prepare for marriage in the spiritual world. You know, how it is when we've got something really cool coming up, like tomorrow's my birthday, or tomorrow's Christmas, and you're really excited, and you're happy, just because, you know, you're going to go on vacation next week, and you're sort of really happy and excited. Well, I think we should all be happy and excited all the time, because we're going to a really good place in the spirit world, in heaven, with God, and with our spouse. And we can be so close to each other, making the foundation, just loving each other, taking care of each other, serving each other, embracing each other, you know, living the Jesus way of life with each other, living the Holy Spirit way of life with each other, forgiving, confessing, sharing everything, just going through life together. That is the foundation for such joy. And I'm going to read you more of Father Moon's words about this. Called by Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit. And this is going to kind of blow you away, I think, because it blows me away. Okay, Father Moon said, if a couple is truly one in heart, when they go to the spirit world, the man can become the woman, and the woman can become the man at any time. If you look into a woman, there's something of a man inside. And when you look into a man, there's something of a woman inside. It is very much the same as God's dual characteristics. Since internal character and external form became divided in order to return to the original being, they must ascend the ladder of love. As the standard of creation originated from love, one must ascend this ladder to return. In the end, our final destination is to be with God. So, wow, it means the power of love. You know, it's the mystery of the Trinity. It's the mystery of how three can become one, and one can become three, and they're completely authentically three, and they're completely authentically one. That's the Trinity that the church proclaimed. And it's hard to believe because we take it on faith as a mystery of the faith, but it's all, St. Augustine explained it. He said, love. Love is the way that the three become one and the one become three. He couldn't go, that's as far as St. Augustine could go. Today, Jesus is taking us to the next step. Three in one comes by love. Husband, wife, God, one. You know, St. Paul said in 2 Corinthians, The husband belongs to his wife. The husband's body belongs to his wife. The wife's body belongs to her husband because they are one. Jesus said, we are one flesh. God said that. And so this means that, yes, you look at the man, you see the woman. You look at the woman, you see the man. They are like indistinguishable in the spirit world in heaven. Of course, they're completely distinguishable. They're completely, I am I and she is she, and yet I am you and you are me. Jesus said, I am in you and you are in me. We are, if you see me, you see the Father. In love, all these things, the boundaries are very clear and strong, and yet because they're so strong and because the love is so strong, we're just melted together. Like the butter melts into the toast. You know, like the butter, I can't think of any other analogy right now. The butter melts into the bagel. You know, you're completely two, and yet you're completely one, and you're so delicious. Okay. Father also said this, true Father said this, Father Moon, when you go to the heavenly kingdom, you must go through a wedding ceremony. Dressed in ceremonial garments, you enter, stand before God, and greet him with love. Husband and wife have a love relationship in front of God. When they make love, God himself rejoices. At the same time, he envelops them from the vertical position. Not only the feelings of the horizontal couple, but those of the entire universe flow and intoxicate them. Thus, they enter an unimaginable world that is like a kaleidoscope. When they love, something amazing happens. Two invisible streams of energy come together and unite completely as one and are assimilated in the world of light. This way of life is brought about with true love. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. We've got a little more to cover on this topic, and we're going to get to it, not next week. We're going to talk about another aspect of spirit world, and that's Halloween, because Halloween's coming up. We're going to talk about that next week and All Saints Day, which is really what Halloween is all about, really. And then week after that, we're going to come back to this topic of marriage in the spirit world, marriage in the resurrection, that even Jesus is excited about this. And I want to thank you for listening. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. We'll talk to you again next week. May God bless you.